Okay, good evening everybody. It's Jim here, and I'm going to show you a video of something that I'm pretty proud of I built, and it's pretty neat. So, there it is. It's quite a spectacular mess, I suppose, but I'm pretty proud of it. It gets the job done. It's my GM station. So let me take you on a little bit of a tour of it, and I'll take some other videos later that kind of shows, you know, it in action, if you will. So the top part, this is a standing GM station. You can see I've got a high stool there, so I can kind of sit lean during the evening. But generally speaking, I find that I'm more productive if I'm standing up. And so it rolls on up next to the table where my players play. And it's got an LCD projector that projects maps and other visual aids down onto the table. It takes about projects about a third of the table. I'll show you guys how I do that with the apps that I use and all that at some other time, future post. But this is generally this is the station. And so I am at one end of the table, and there's still room to walk around. But generally I stand over here, and I can still make eye contact with my players even as they're sitting down. So I'm going to take you in a little bit closer so you can see the features of it. But this is the top. You can see I've got a variety of things there. I've got the bottom down here, storage at the bottom. It's on some locking casters. I don't know if you can see those, but they're pretty heavy duty because I roll this in and out of my office on game night. And I've actually had to make the projector fold down so that I can get it through the door. Because otherwise it just doesn't fit. So let's look at the top here. The first part of my station is really the GM screen area. I built a little wall. Down goes calculator. I built a little wall, and behind that wall, or in front of that wall, whichever you want to think about it, are these three sets of bins. And they hold my pre-paint, my dungeon, D&D pre-paint minis. Got quite a few of those. Got a lot of duplicates, so I can throw out hordes and hordes of critters at my players. Some various other doodads and widgets that I use. Pencils. This bin actually holds all the PC minis and some other NPC minis and so forth. I've got just enough room between these, and that's kismet, not planning, to squeeze in some of the books that I use the most. I've got my tube of rats. Christian will know about those. They're pretty awesome. I use a lot of cards, which I make up at Go Deck Yourself, and so here's a little stack of some cards that are ready to deploy. There's an astral giant. I also use battle mats. Even though I project, it's still handy to be able to draw. And so I have a microfiber cloth and some spray bottle there. Got a lot of dice. These are some resources that I'm using. These are actual, there's Nox Bell. Go get yourself a copy. Anyway, these are references that I've used during the games. And I should do a post about these sometime, but I've created a spreadsheet that I can run, and it gives me a variety of random encounters and random dungeon dressing, a variety of things that help me sort of plan and brainstorm the adventure. This is a map that I pulled out of an adventure, some handouts, but this is my random hit dice. Keep track of hit points and wounds on this page. More random. These are random encounter tables from the Castle of the Mad Archmage. Random dungeon dressing from Katma. Got something else in here, too. Oh, here's the random factions, random special encounters, and other random monsters that come up. And so I usually print one of these for each adventure. I have a date. I give it a name afterwards, and then this becomes part of the player or the campaign record. So I've got a bunch of those. Here's my Craftsman little die rolling bin. Use that during the course of the game. I also have a die roller that I'd like to use more, but it's still a little bit clumsy to try to use. I've also put a layer of plexiglass. I don't know if you can see that, but there's plexiglass down on the table so that I can put some of my handy-dandy reference charts right here on the table to use at any time. This is Ravenport. This is the city, the home city. One of my players drew this up. Actually, a couple of my players drew this up collaboratively, but the colored image is one player's work. Really, a random encounter chart that I'm actually quite fond of from one of the early Dragon magazines. Printed that up. Here's my sudden death and dismemberment table. Love that. Some OD&D combat sequence. This is my generic die. Roll percentiles or roll whatever. You can get different results anyway. This is my modified saving throw system. I've got some other little random charts here to spark creativity. This is one of those span direct artichokes. This is one of those charts. I want to say this was at 9 and 30 Kingdoms. Talisman posted this, I think. This is from Chicago Wiz's blog here, the attack bonus, but I think it's